and welcome to our program, the best insight analysis of President Donald Trump's countless sensational scams. Me Faria Mejmin from your favorite channel Lifestyle, along with
Anwarul Islam,
Salwa Mehreen.
I appreciate both of your time. Did you know President Donald Trump's now facing 17 state, local and federal probes, 17 ongoing investigations. Is he trying to go in the Guinness Book of World Records?
Basically three big areas that should cause of him concern, issues about money laundering, obstruction to justice, and above all, collusion.
Faria, you know, Trump dissolved his charity amid allegations that he has used it for his personal and political benefits.
That's right. Trump has agreed to shut down his personal charity, the Trump Foundation, in the wake of the succession scandals and looming lawsuit which exposed a shocking pattern of illegality. He had used the charity to pay off legal settlements within his business and even to buy a painting of himself to hang in on of his golf club. Now, Salwa, you tell us, did he try to obstruct justice by firing the FBI chief James Comey?
Trump has long claimed that the Mueller investigation is a hoax and witch hunt. He sometimes acknowledged the interference of Russians in 2016 election, but denies any collusion on that the Russians' meddling contributed to his victory. Now, the former FBI director James Comey, who was fired by Donald Trump in May 2017 while he was leading an investigation into Russians' interference in 2016 US election and possible Trump campaign collusion, made his remarks that President Donald Trump of undermining the rules of law in United States by lying about FBI, and he also urged the Republican lawmakers to stand up and speak the truth about Trump's behavior.
Another former Trump advisor, Michael Flynn, to be sentenced for lying to FBI today. Senate report also showed the scope of Russian election meddling. So what do you make of it, Dad?
Russia used fake social media accounts to influence the 2016 election, stirring up the American voters by using angry and polarizing messages. You know, Washington Post reports Russia interacted with at least 14 Trump associates during the campaign and transition.
Trump's countless scams are finally catching up to him. Various reports consistently depicting him as a clown, a racist, an orange monkey, Dr. Evil, and even called his actions treasonous. Salwa, my question is to you, what will happen to him next?
Justice Department guidelines suggest that a sitting president cannot be indicted. Mueller could write a report which concludes there is evidence of crime and the Democratic head house could begin their impeachment proceedings.
Faria, you see, Trump keeps lying all the time. He is in legal troubles, but not democracy dies in darkness. In America, you see, the media, the judiciary, they are free. The people who are pleaded guilty, they are sentenced by the judges without any intervention.
I do agree with you wholeheartedly. The verdicts by the judges are important victory for the rule of law, making clear that there is one set of rules for everyone. Live long, democracy.